Hey there, everybody. I am so excited to be able to sit down with you again and have a conversation about the state of the scientific enterprise and the budgetary landscape supporting that scientific enterprise. You know, when I was a kid, I used to dream about being alive during one of the golden eras of science. What would it be like to have a conversation with Einstein in 1905? Or to sit around and talk about the development of quantum mechanics with the physicists in the 1920s and 30s? Or to have a wonderful dinner conversation with the biologists working out the central dogma of biology in the 60s and 70s. But what I've come to realize over 3 years in this role as the CEO of the AAAS is that I prefer to be alive in this time, this moment. We are living in the golden era of science right now. We are on the cusp of discoveries in almost every discipline that are amazing, that will change the way we think about the universe and change the way we think about ourselves. All of that is because of the investments that we've been making over the last 75 years in research and development. Those investments are being made by private industry, they're being made by philanthropy, and probably most importantly, they're being made by the U.S. federal government. To ensure that those advances continue, we have to maintain our investment in science and technology. And to do that requires getting into the U.S. appropriations process. Now, for those of you who do science every day, I've got to tell you, the appropriations process is as complicated as the cell cycle. It's as complicated as simulating the Big Bang. It's as complicated as any scientific process that you can imagine. And because of that, it requires having experts understanding it and helping affect it. And we have that here at the AAAS. You've probably been hearing about the brinksmanship surrounding the debt ceiling. And the first thing I want to do here is thank Congress and the President for coming to an agreement on the debt ceiling. That was an important act of governing. That said, the debt ceiling agreement limits Congress's ability to provide adequate funding for science and technology, unless it's made an absolute priority. Over the next 6 months, Congress is going to be making its way through the appropriations process. At AAAS and within the scientific community, we have to ensure that Congress sees investment in science and technology as a priority for the country. To do that requires understanding the budget process just as well as we understand the cell cycle or the Big Bang. At AAAS, our understanding of the budget process tells us that to ensure adequate investment in science and technology in fiscal year 2024, it may require designating some investment in science as an emergency for the purposes of budgeting. Now, that's all way too complex to get into in this sit-down. And so, we've set up a conversation in our member community and a Q&A session with our experts. I invite you to join that upcoming conversation. The reason that we are working so hard to ensure this funding is that I want a child that is born today to have the same dream about this era that I had about sitting down with Einstein, or sitting down with the physicists in the 20s, or sitting down with the biologists in the 60s. This era needs to continue. If you're not a member, please join so that you can be a part of the conversation in the AAAS member community. In future sit-downs, I look forward to chatting with you about the budgetary landscape and about the amazing scientific advances that those budgets make possible. I hope you'll join me.